Hello everyone, welcome to Kira Tech Hub. My name is Paulina Mwakira, and today we'll be doing a Databricks on AWS end-to-end workshop. So in this workshop, you're going to learn how to integrate Databricks with AWS services, the steps of ingesting data into S3, performing ETL on Databricks. We are going to create a simple machine learning model, which is going to make predictions, and also learn how to integrate a dashboard on QuickSight and also Power BI. So I hope you'll enjoy having this. This workshop is mainly aimed at data engineers, data scientists, data analysts, Databricks users too, and anyone just who wants to learn how to utilize data on AWS and perform ETL on it using Databricks. And also for those who just want to know how to collaborate on the Databricks platform. So just to share an overview of what you're going to cover, we have this SAP data that you're going to ingest into Amazon S3. You can utilize Amazon Upflow to do the copying of the data, but in my workshop, I won't be doing this. I'll just be copying data directly to an S3 bucket, some SAP data. After that, we have to do some data preparations with Databricks on AWS. And this is the part where you're seeing all this stuff going on. So what is happening over here? We are going to create some silver tables. Let me clear this. So we are going to create some silver tables and gold tables using PySpark. And the bronze table contains the raw data as it is ingested. Silver table, we do some cleaning on the data and some simple joins. So the join data will be on the silver table, and then the gold table will be used for aggregation and analysis. So we are joining, cleansing tables and formatting data so that we can use that data for machine learning to train our model. This is on the Databricks Auto ML. And we are going to develop a machine learning model with Databricks. So we are going to register with MLflow model registry. I won't be deploying the model to SageMaker, but that is something you can do as well if you want to integrate it with other AWS services. And then now once our model is able to create data for forecasting, we can visualize that data using QuickSight, which is our business intelligence tool used to create interactive dashboards on AWS, but I will also show you how to integrate with Power BI for those organizations who use Power BI. So that is it. What we need to set up for this setup to work, so you'll need an AWS account, preferably an administrator account, which will allow you us to create the resources we need, and you also need a Databricks administrator account with admin privileges. So if you don't have a Databricks administrator account, you can go to this URL, www.databricks.com. So this is the URL, and you can just go ahead, say, try Databricks. And you can use the Express just to quickly get hands-on with Databricks, and Databricks will manage the cloud infrastructure, but you can also continue use an existing cloud account if you have an AWS account and you want to manage your own computer and storage. Because I want us to see all the options we have possible, I'll go with managing everything in my own account. So you're going to go ahead, create a Databricks account, put your email, and you can also use personal email, doesn't have to be your corporate email. Enter all the things needed. So for example, I'll just do test@gmail.com. No need. And what I want to be able to learn, I'm just learning on Databricks. Continue. And now you're going to pick your cloud provider. So you need admin access to the cloud account you are using, which is either AWS, Azure, or Google platform. And you'll actually have $400 in credits, and you'll be given a 14-day AWS trial, same with Azure, same with Google Cloud. So, and these credits are not for AWS services, for the Databricks services that are going to be created. And you can go ahead, click continue. you'll be directed to the AWS marketplace where you're going to create a Databricks cluster. So what you are going to see over here. So you can purchase this. It's a software as a service from the marketplace. We are going to get $400 in credits for the 14-day trial, and then I can go ahead, try for free. Specify my AWS account, which should have admin access. So deployed on AWS, get the details on pricing, go ahead, subscribe. And after you subscribe, of which I already have a subscription, so you can set up, you can go ahead and set up your account on the vendor's website using that email you specified. So set up your account. And so you'll see all the details needed, the Databricks account, and you can either create an account or link an existing account from the email. And you specify the email address, your first name, your last name, and your company. Sign up for Databricks. And the next thing after you link up your Databricks account, is going to configure a workspace for you, which contains all the things you'll be needing, where you'll be running your clusters and so on. So that is how you go ahead with setting up your Databricks AWS, your Databricks account. Now, after you have that set up, okay, so you'll be asked your email address. We'll receive a code. So I just used this random account for the free tier version. And this is what you see once you log in on the Databricks platform. You have the workspaces, the different catalogs that you have set up, usage. You can manage your users over here. Set up some cloud resources like storage configuration. We'll see what that is about. And all the different settings. So you'll have information about the credits. So remember, you're given 400 credits, and you'll see like how many credits you have remaining after that. So this point where they're saying configure workspace, what they will do for you is set up a workspace. Now, if to create a workspace quickly in AWS, and just come back here and say create workspace. This is an environment to access your Databricks data. And it's as simple as that. Next. Databricks on AWS. Let's go with US West too, no problem. So I want to change the name for now. I acknowledge and create stuff. So you can see the resources that are being created. A bucket policy for a bucket. We have a workspace bucket where our tables are going to be stored. Some functions, the roles to give the necessary permissions to communicate with Databricks. And yeah, that's basically it. We'll wait a few moments for our stack to be available. And my stack is in a create complete phase. And if I come here and refresh, there is this new workspace that has been created for me in the US West 2 region, and so on and so on. So I can now click on it and open it. And now start working with data. Cool. So we see lots of different features. We have the workspace. We have the catalog where we'll be creating our tables and so on. We have the SQL where we have the SQL editor. We can run our queries, dashboards. We have Jenny, whereby you can ask your questions about your data in a natural language. We have different alerts. We can see the query history. In data engineering, when you run jobs and pipelines, you can see the job runs there, and also data ingestion. So this is where you can do some monitoring on failed jobs and rerun them. And then we have the AIML, whereby you can do some machine learning experiments, build your models, serve your models, deploy them, and so on. So first things first, we have to get data from S3. So I'll be importing data directly into Databricks from an S3 bucket. And first we need an S3 bucket whereby we are going to copy our data to. So I'll be utilizing the Cloud Shell for that. So the first things first, write a command over here to get my account ID, and I can echo that because I want to use this in my bucket. So that's it. Now my bucket name. So my bucket name is going to be the account ID, upload data, and today's date. So my bucket name should basically look like this. That's okay. And now I'm going to copy some data. So we are going to copy data from a public S3 bucket, which is owned by AWS, containing SAP data into this bucket that you are going to create. And the directory structure is similar to the one that I shared before in over here. So we have some sales document, which contains the header data, the item data, and we are going to copy these two files into a specific S3 bucket. So back over here, so I'm specifying, let me create my bucket. Cool. And now I specify the different directories I have. So the sales header directory should be that. And the second directory, which contains the item data, should be that. And now I use the copy command. So from this public S3 bucket into the bucket name I have created. And so that was for the sales header directory. And the second one was for the item, sales item directory. So if I go back over here and navigate back to S3. So today is the July of 15th. This should be the bucket I have created right now from the command line. And you see it as the two objects, the two folders we created, and the files, the parquet files have been uploaded over there. So we are going to review that. So next thing now is to prepare our data and using the Databricks service. So we are going to create a Databricks cluster to run our compute jobs. So under compute, I'm going to create compute. So this cluster, I can specify, because I'll be using it for machine learning. So it will come pre-installed with libraries like the PyTorch, TensorFlow, blah, blah, blah. And I can just specify this is for personal compute or unrestricted compute. You specify the runtime that you want. I'll just specify this is going to be a single node. And I want to terminate after, for example, 60 minutes of inactivity. And apart from that, we have some advanced details which you can set up. For example, something very important is the instance profile. If you're going to be using this cluster, and it needs to access other services. Like, for example, in this case, where we had before, our cluster should be able to maybe access SageMaker, or it should be able to access S3. We have the instance profile, which is, so for S3, instance profile is one way to do that. But if we have other services rather than S3, maybe I want to push an image to ECR and so on, I am going to create an instance profile. So for those who are familiar with the AWS landscape, we must be familiar with what an instance profile is, a role that contains temporary permissions. And if you want services to communicate to each other, we normally attach an instance profile to our cluster, basically. So, but in this case, I won't be attaching any, but that is one thing you should be looking out to. If your cluster needs access to other AWS S3 services, you attach an instance profile. An instance profile is just basically a role that has the permissions you need. So where you actually create this instance profile, if we go over here and in my cluster and go to the settings, and just some of the admin settings, and we can go to security. Yeah, security. So here you can set up an instance profile which provides secure access to data in S3, among other things. But you can see there is a note here that Databricks recommends using the Unity Catalog external locations to connect to S3 instead of using instance profile. So in this demo, I'll be using the recommended way. But how to create an instance profile? You just manage, add an instance profile in this workspace, and you'll give the instance profile ARN and the IAM role ARN. So an example, I should have an example of a role. If I go to identity and access management, so, and you create a role. This is going to be definitely a service role for EC2. So I have an example of a role like, let me see, the Databricks cluster SageMaker access role. Take a look at this role. This is a service role which allows EC2 instances to call AWS services on my behalf. And you can see the permissions I have given it. Apart from S3, maybe it should have access to SageMaker and the EC2 container registry, because I needed that, and the trust relationships, who can assume this role. So over there, you're going to, for example, allow EC2, but you're going to get information about the trust relationship to put in place. So one of the things you can see over here as part of the trust relationship is the principal. We want to allow, this is provided by Databricks itself. You can see this account ID is not my own account ID. So you have to specify that, and it's part of the Databricks documentation. You'll get information on what principles you should allow to have access to our cluster. So that is the trust policy. And now, if you are creating an instance profile, we just put the role ARN over here and the instance profile ARN over here. And so it worked out. So that is how you create an instance profile. So now if I go to instance profiles and manage, I can see the Databricks cluster, SageMaker access role. And now over here, I can select that role and attach it to my cluster. So that is if you need other permissions. So I'll show you another way to go about it to access S3. We have the initialization scripts. If you have any, you need the instances, you can specify the availability zone you want and so on, the EBS volume type. So this compute is actually going to be created in AWS. So I'm going to create.
¶¶